today I'm going to talk about the washing machine, and I'm going to wash some clothes. I have sheets. They're dirty because everything in Laos gets dirty. I wash them about once a week because they get so dirty. Here's the washing machine. There's the washing part where it fills up with water. There's some dials. And then the spinning mechanism, which is as close to a dryer as you get here in Laos. They don't have heated dryers. The dials are the wash timer, how hard you want it to wash, gentle, normal, or strong. The drain selector, which do you drain or keep the water. Spin timer. We're going to put the drain on wash and then move it to there when time to drain, then strong, and I'm going to turn the timer on when I finish filling it up. So, turning the water on, I have to wait for it to fill up, and then I'll turn the water off. This is the soap detergent. I'm almost out, and I'm just going to fill it up. One thing about the soap here is that it comes in all sorts of sizes. The little size, the medium size, and an enormous size. I'm going to use bleach today. This is the bleach bottle, written in Thai. I will add that once it fills up. And let me add the clothes. I am probably going to let them soak. All right, turning the timer on to 16 minutes, and notice it just spins them around. I will probably let it fill up and let the wash timer run through about 16 minutes. May turn it on again because the sheets are a little, just get really dirty, and let the bleach soak in. I will show you phase two after this finishes. So, phase one of laundry. Okay, phase two. The clothes have been soaking and washing. I put them through two cycles. Here they are, all soapy. And now the object of phase two is to get the soap out of the clothes and ready to dry. So, this phase involves putting the clothes into the spinner, letting all the soap, getting all the soap out. So I'll put the clothes into the spinner very quickly. And once they're in the spinner, I'm going to drain the main washing. All that will go outside my house, just kind of drain out into the lawn. And that'll turn the spinner on. And the clothes, you can actually hear them spinning. Part of the trick is listening to see if the clothes are balanced in the spinner. So at this point, the spinner sounds a little off. So I'm going to open it up. And yeah, see, the top's off. So. One thing that's nice is that you can put water into the washer and the spinner. So after I press this down, I'm going to turn the switch to the spinning side, and then I'm going to turn the water on. Alright, so this helps rinse the clothes in the spinner. I'll leave it on a little bit. It also helps maybe get the spinner balanced. So turn the water off. Try again. Try to put the spinner, and hopefully it'll go this time. So you can hear the spinner going, and hopefully it sounds better this time. Phase two is finished. Okay, phase three. The spinner is almost done. About to undo a minute. I have drained the washing part, and all the water is out. So I'm going to put it back there and put clean water in there and let it fill up. This time I'm going to put the clothes that were just spun into there and get all the soap out. So it's kind of like a soak cycle after they've been done spinning. And now we just got to wait 30 seconds for the spinner to go. So that's part of it. And okay, spinner's done. So we are going to take the clothes out of the spinner and put them into the washer and let them wash the clothes out from all the soap and everything else. It's nice because as a clothes are in a spinner, you can always push the water over and give them a bit of a rinse. So the clothes now come out of the spinner into the washer really fast. Alright, this is phase 3. They're gonna sit in there and agitate and get all the soap out, and I'm just gonna shut it until it's done. So phase 3 done. Okay, phase 4. The clothes have been soaking, and see, there's still a little bit of soap in them. Now what I want to do is I want to get one of the sheets out and into the spinner at a time. So this takes a little while because they're soaked and attached to each other. Alright, I've got one in the spinner. I'm going to turn it on, and this time I'm going to let it spin really well so that when I lay it out to dry, it'll be mostly ready. And the other one's going to sit there until the other one's done in the spinner. Okay, phase 5, last phase. We are spinning the clothes for the last time, and I'm going to hang them up. All right, I wait for this to spin. I will take these out, and then I will put the other one in the spinner and finish these off. So I'm just going to switch these out real fast and start the spinner for this sheet and wait to see how the spinner starts and then move into the other room. Okay, one problem with drying clothes here is that there's only two ways you can dry it: in the sun or just hanging it up. So today is a good day because the sun is bright, and I will hang the clothes in front of my front door so that the sun, afternoon sun, can hit it and dry it. And once the clothes are hung up, notice that the sun is hitting most of it. When it goes down, it should hit it all. And this is a lot faster drying than just hanging the clothes up. I've got a clothes hanging device here, which I put underneath the fan, and it does a decent job, but it's just not as fast. So the clothes should dry much faster here. Now, phase 5 is almost finished, just doing the same thing to the other sheet, waiting for the spinner to finish, and then to hang it up in the sun. Phase 5 is finished, and this is how we wash clothes down here in Pakse. I'll be happy when these are dry.